Hello, welcome to Arizona State University. My name is Brent Siebold. I'm with ASU Entrepreneurship and Innovation. I also teach within our Ira A. Fulton Schools of Engineering. So I'm here to introduce this crazy concept of entrepreneurship to you all. Many of you might be thinking, what the heck are we talking about entrepreneurship for? Let me take you back in time. Our president, Michael Crow, in 2002, created some design aspirations for the entire university. So not just any one specific college or school, but for all of us here, part of this enterprise. And as you see on this list, there's actually 8 things, but the third on the list is to value entrepreneurship. So that's for everybody. How do we value entrepreneurship? So part of that challenge is historically, as you might be thinking, entrepreneurship has been connected to our business school and to other disciplines that are kind of grounded in commerce. But really what I'm here to share with you today is we want to reframe entrepreneurship to be something that all of us can innately latch onto and make the world a better place. So let's try to redefine it. So in my definition, and some of my colleagues share this with me, we want to bake this down to the first step in the entrepreneurial process, and that's to solve problems and to recognize gaps out in the world and to be creative about the ways that we make the world a better place. And if we figure out how to do that correctly, and a lot of times it takes trial and error, entrepreneurship is the vehicle by which we can expand our good ideas and our working prototypes and all the fun stuff that we do in the lab and in the residence hall and in the garage. So what I really want to share with you today is this kind of movement that's afoot across all disciplines, especially within our schools of engineering right now, is this concept of entrepreneurial mindset. So regardless of what you're studying, we want to combine the skill set that you're going to get over the next 4 or 5 years in the classroom with what we call an entrepreneurial mindset. And this is comprised of 3 C's: curiosity, connections, and creating value. So the first one, all we want you to do is keep an open mind. Be on the lookout for friction points that exist within your own life. Are there things that annoy you? Are there things that bug you? Are there opportunities that might be present within your neighborhood or within your path in life? So if you're curious and you keep your eyes and ears open, that's the first step of being able to recognize opportunities to make the world a better place. So curiosity is key. Next, obviously, when we're unpacking the term entrepreneurial mindset, we want to move on to, once we identify a potential problem, how can we then be creative? And I know you all are, about coming up with potentially a novel solution or something that makes that solution that might already be available just a little bit better for your particular scenario or a friend's particular scenario. So this isn't an equation. You can create, this can be art, it can be music, it can be poetry and everything in between. So entrepreneurship isn't necessarily tied to commerce at this stage. It's tied to creating something new that's never been done before, which is super exciting. We love to do it here at ASU. And of course, your mindset is your attitude and your motivation. If you're here with us today, I have every confidence that you have the correct mindset to make the world a better place and solve for X. Next is connect. So this one, yeah, we can connect with our friends, our classmates, we can go out and meet people in the world, but really at this stage of the game, when you identify a friction point or a problem, it's actually much easier than that. You just want to see who else has tried to solve this before, because in many cases you think you might have the exact right idea that you came up with in the shower this morning, but you might quickly find by doing a Google search that someone else has already tried to tackle this problem. But that's a good thing. If you see that somebody has already attempted to create a solution for a problem that you're experiencing, you want to learn from that person or organization and potentially piggyback on what they've already done. And if you don't want to type into your browser, you can just speak into your smart speaker and they'll pull up the same results. And then beyond that, the hard work is really going out into the marketplace and into the society and talking to real humans, just like yourself, that can either validate or, more importantly, reject some of the hypotheses you're making about, A, is the problem actually a problem, or is there another associated problem that's even more painful? And then when it comes to the point of connecting to possible solutions, these other humans that are out in the world want to help you create the correct solution, because that's going to make their lives better and hopefully all of our lives better. So as you're prototyping, don't be afraid to sketch out what this might look like on paper, using cardboard, whatever you have at hand is a quick and easy way to iteratively prototype out and think through possible solutions and features and all that fun stuff. And then finally, if you get this right, and those first two steps are very hard, being curious, looking for opportunities, connecting with what has happened before and others that are trying to solve in the same domain to finally create value and to develop some sort of product or solution or service or whatever it might be that can really make people's lives better. And then we'll call the business folks up and say, hey, can you help us develop a business model to sustain this well into the future so that we can make our neighborhood, our state, our country, and our world a much better place? So join me in helping this young lady. She's interacting with a prototype that we came up with in 10 minutes in class. And she's very excited about, interacting with this value that we've developed through this prototype. So many of you, again, welcome to ASU. You might be wondering, hey, I'm at the number one university for innovation in the country, 3 years running, maybe four by the time you watch this video. What exactly does that mean? So this isn't invention. I mean, it is, but it's also a couple steps beyond that. We want to create something that's better than what already exists. And if it's better, there's a very good likelihood that people are going to be willing to give you something in return, which then creates a sustainable method of making the world a better place. So without further ado, welcome to Arizona State University, number one in the U.S. for innovation. We're so glad to have you as part of our crew, as part of our enterprise. So if you ever need to reach out to us and talk through some of these things that I've introduced to you here today, don't hesitate. You can find us on the web or just talk to your instructor here today and we'll get you connected. Again, welcome to ASU and go Devils.